This video is going to be about evaluating functions, and I'm actually going to do a couple of videos about this. In this one, what I want to talk about is how to evaluate a function when you're given the function algebraically, and also I want to talk a little bit about how you interpret functions when you've got a word problem. In the second video, I'll talk about evaluating functions when you have a graph or a table. So let's get going with this one. Here I've got this function, f of x equals 2x squared over x minus 3. And remember, what this means is I can replace the x in the left side of the function with any number I want. And that will tell me what my function equals when instead of an x I have that number. So in other words, if I'm told to evaluate, let's say, f of 4, then all I'm going to do is take the 4, put it in wherever I have an x, so I'm going to have 2 times 4 squared instead of 2 times x squared, and that's going to be over 4 minus 3. In other words, this part on the right, 2 times 4 squared over 4 minus 3, is what the function equals when the input is 4. So let's find out what that is. Well, 4 squared is 16, and 2 times 16 is 32. And then 4 minus 3 is 1, so I don't even have to write the 1 as a denominator. So basically, f of 4 equals 32. Now, what you want to remember about this is, remember, the 4 is the input, and the 32 is the output of the function. In other words, I could think of the input as an independent variable and the output as a dependent variable, and I could take this f of 4 equals 32, and I could also write it as an ordered pair, 4, 32, and that would tell me that in my original general function, f of x equals 2x squared over x minus 3, 4, 32 would be a solution to that, and it would also be a point on the graph. Okay, so you can take what you got out of a function and turn it into an ordered pair. Let's look at another value instead of x. Let's say I've got f of 3, and I want to evaluate that. Well, I'll do the same process. That means instead of 2x squared as a numerator, I'm going to have 2 times 3 squared. That's going to be over, instead of x minus 3, I'll have 3 minus 3. And then I can evaluate that. But if I take a good look at it, I can save myself some work. Look at the denominator, 3 minus 3. Well, 3 minus 3 is 0. And I'm not allowed to have a 0 in the denominator as the denominator of a fraction. So that means I can't evaluate f of 3. And the number 3 would be out of the domain of the function. It would not be part of the function because I can't put a 3 into it. I can't have a 3 as my input. Okay? Let's look at something a little more complicated. Let's say I want f of x plus 3. Okay, so remember, all that means is I'm going to take this x plus 3 and put it into my original function wherever I had an x. So I'll have 2 times the expression x plus 3, and I'm squaring that, and that's going to be over x plus 3 minus 3. All I did was replace the x plus 3 into every place where I had an x. And then I'll just evaluate what this is. So you know that x plus 3 squared means it's x plus 3 times x plus 3. So I'm going to have 2 times x plus 3 over x plus 3. I'm sorry, 2 times x plus 3 times x plus 3 over, let's see, x plus 3, I don't need these parentheses in the denominator anymore, x plus 3 minus 3. And now all I have left to do is multiply my x plus 3 times x plus 3 and take care of the rest of this. So I have to remember that's all multiplied by 2. So it's going to be 2 times, and then my parentheses, x times x is x squared. X times 3 is 3x. 3x times, 3 times x is 3, is another 3x. And 3 times 3 is 9. And that's all going to be over, let's see, x plus 3 minus 3 is just x. And I can collect like terms. So I'm still going to have 2 times x squared plus 6x plus 9 over x. And I'll end up by distributing this 2. So I'll have 2x squared, 2 times 6x is 12x, 2 times 9 is 18, and that's all over 6. So f of x plus 3 equals 2x squared plus 12x plus 18 over x. Okay? So the main thing to remember about these is all you're doing is you're taking what you're supposed to evaluate the function for. It may be a number, it may be an expression like x plus 3, and you put that into the original function wherever you had the x, okay? Or whatever your input variable originally was. And then you just do whatever math you have to do, simplify it down until you get your answer. Okay, now I just want to take a second and talk about word problems. So here's a typical word problem you might run into when you're dealing with functions. The owner of a small movie theater finds that his daily profit can be modeled with the function p of n equals 2n minus 150, where p is the profit in dollars and n is the number of tickets sold. Interpret P of 110 equals 70 in the context of this problem. This is really much, much easier than it sounds. I know it sounds kind of scary. So let's see what they're telling us. P is the profit in dollars. Okay? And N is the number of tickets sold. Okay, all we have to do is remember that. So P of 110, now the 110 has replaced the N. So that means when the number of tickets sold is 110, this whole thing equals 70, which is what P equals, and P is the profit in dollars. So when 110 tickets are sold, the profit in dollars is $70. Okay? And that's all there is to it. Don't be scared by the words. There may be a situation you don't even understand. As long as you know what the variables stand for, you can interpret something like this, P of 110 equals 70. Okay? So that's it. Take care. I'll see you next time.